This is a very well-coached Bob McKillop Davidson team with a two-time MVP of the SoCon tournament. This guy is an undersized post, Brooks, but he can play. And in the front court, the team will build around these two guys. Can the ancillary parts do their job?
Let's get to the starting lineups now for Davidson. They have some big guards now. Sullivan, Kalinowski, Droney goes 6-6. Cherepovich is 6'7", and of course Brooks is the motor that makes them go. For Duke, no real center among the starting five, and Cook, Thornton, Hood, Parker, and Jefferson. We are ready for the opening tip. For Duke, the 109th season of college basketball. For Davidson, their 106th, as you look at our officials for tonight, game one. And ready to get it underway. And immediately knocked out of play on the opening tip, and so Davidson will have control.
Two things you'd like to see from Davidson if you're Bob McKillop. One, stay out of foul trouble because there's experience in the first five, but their depth is young. The second thing, make some shots. Try to get your nerves under control here in a tough venue by making shots and getting off to a good start.
Brian Sullivan will run the point, gets it off immediately, shot in the air for three, and a quick start.
Now, Davidson is a team under Bob McKillop that will shoot the ball well from five positions. They will run their motion offense, read, react, cut, a lot of activity that Duke will have to guard.
Kalinowski not afraid to get it in the air. Here's Jabari Parker, knocks it down. The first shot he takes in college basketball. What a start.
Young man has got superstar written all over him. 6'8", athletic and skilled.
235 out of Chicago. He's already appeared on the cover of Sports Illustrated, proclaiming him as the best player to come along since LeBron. And bodied up, and immediately a quick foul that'll be committed by Tyler Thornton.
We have seen plenty of great players in Cameron Indoor Stadium rock the white jerseys. Jabari Parker, the latest, and yes, no stage fright, makes his first opportunity.
Droney, a 6'6 senior. He's a guy who also loves to shoot it. He's appeared in every game in his Davidson career, so they have experience to rely on. Sullivan down the lane. He's denied. Picked off by Parker. Now to run. And look for this out of Duke this year. A faster tempo. That's what they're trying to do, and really pile up points.
Speed. Speed, athleticism, outstanding pass right there from Jabari Parker.
And Jefferson in for two, the 6'9 sophomore.
And they like Jefferson's ability to play off the two forwards.
Three-pointer, that's going to rattle out by Cherepovich out of Gothenburg, Sweden, but he can really shoot it. If he gets going, look out. Hood gives it up, and now Cook will call out the play, the point guard, the junior out of Washington, D.C. On the move, Hood, a little tumble there, the jumper on the way, and that's going to rattle home, and he's done it again. Parker has five quick points. But they'll give up two on the other end. Kalinowski on the drive.
Yeah, that's the one area. You see the dynamic offensive ability from Jabari Parker. Watching practice yesterday, the defensive end, he's got a lot of growth. He's at the perfect place to sort of be taught defensive technique.
Thornton swings up high. Now Cook to set up a play for the Blue Devils. Went 30-6 a season ago. Wound up second place in the ACC as Cook drives in two. Look at Davidson not wasting any time, but a traveling violation here on Cherepovich. Mike Krzyzewski now in his 34th season at the helm. Duke is 31-2 in season openers under Coach K.
Were you sort of surprised? We sat with him just moments ago. Guy's got 957 wins, a gold medal, which he says admits to the pressure of that. He said, I still get jitters. He's nervous.
Said he still gets nervous. Smooth-looking jump shot there by Rodney Hood. Quite a rarity at Duke. A transfer. Just the fourth transfer that Coach K has had here in 34 years.
Well, that transfer just gave him a 12-2 run.
Sullivan to Brooks. A touch for him, and he's fouled on the play. So 16:57 to go here in the opening half. Bob McKillop, head coach for Davidson, and one of the most respected coaches in the game. He was selected to be the head coach for Team USA at last summer's World University Games in Russia.
This is 25th year on the sideline at Davidson, a great high school coach in New York prior to moving his family and coming here. He's had opportunities to go other places, but Davidson and Bob McKillop seem to fit seamlessly. This is a guy who walks to work. They live across the street from campus.
A tremendous family connections to the university. Two there for Damon Brooks, the senior from Charlotte.
There's a great article in the Charlotte Observer about Bob McKillop. In fact, one of his former colleagues when he was an assistant coach at Davidson for 1 year before going back to coach high school basketball was Rick Barnes. Rick Barnes called him the best coach in North Carolina. I thought, don't Roy Williams and Mike Krzyzewski coach in North Carolina?
There's a couple of Hall of Famers there. Not that Bob hasn't done a spectacular job. He has, and his resume is marked with big, big upsets. Hood on the drive, a lot of contact. Follows it up and knocks it down. He has five.
It is blatantly obvious before the first TV timeout why Mike Krzyzewski has said the rest of the returnees will adjust around the two new guys. Hood and Parker are immense talents.
Jake Belford into the ballgame now for the Davidson Wildcats as Brooks tries to operate in heavy traffic. Into the lane on the spin and a shove as Parker connected with the foul. And one thing you may want to look for, a couple of rule changes that are allowing a lot less contact than in previous years, and one of those is placing and keeping a hand or a forearm on an opponent. That's not to say if you touch somebody, it's an automatic foul, because it's not, but hand checking is going to be clamped down on.
And Carl Hess made it obvious what he was calling there. He made the hand checking motion, and the reason being they feel like the game got too physical and there wasn't enough movement and offensive abilities being showcased.
Well, look at the moves there by Damon Brooks, who is the man for Davidson, All-Southern Conference, three times, player of the year in the conference as well.
They've had a hard time with this guy in the past. He's an undersized post at this level, but in his league, he is very, very difficult to contend with.
Good looking to penetrate. Now back out, Harrison off the fake. He'll fire it up. And a whistle will go the other way. Foul here against Duke with 15:41 to go in the half.
Well, Jabari Parker got a fast start to his Duke career officially. Yes, he dominated in preseason, but the lights are on and he's ready. Jumper drained. Duke in charge early. This program, one, they attack space, meaning you've got to fight for every inch of real estate on the basketball court. Catch and see. He calls it a boo dribble when you put it down on the floor too fast, like B-O-O. You can't put it on the deck without purpose and then help someone out. And you know what was fascinating to me watching their practice today and Duke's yesterday? How much both guys talked so often about communication and helping your teammate be a better player. You know, basketball is a simple game.
Yeah, both coaches, very similar philosophies when they talk about five men working as one. Those are very, very interesting mantras between the two of them. 15:41 to go here in the first half. Davidson with the basketball. 26-8 last year. 17-1 in the Southern Conference. They won the league, a league that is, like many of them, in a state of flux right now. Throwing into the lane. That's a tough move with the left hand for two.
It is, and I don't necessarily think Bob McKillop might have loved the possession because he was the only one to touch it, and he did a ton of dribbling, but you'll take the score.
Good penetrating again on the dish. Murphy into the ballgame now. Alex Murphy, the blocking foul. Sophomore out of Wakefield, Rhode Island, part of the outstanding depth that Duke has.
Now, this is part of what Mike Krzyzewski was talking about pregame. Like everybody else in the country, you don't know yet what your rotations are. You might have an idea, and against certain matchups, you might play certain guys, but everything is new. How many minutes can Jabari Parker play before he's fatigued and makes young mistakes? All of these things develop over the course of your season.
Says, I know what I can do. I don't know what I'm going to do with this team yet.
Yes.
And how they're going to react. Cook with a long one. Got it. Went Cook.
See, I think he's crucial. Because we've seen Cook over the last couple of years, and when he plays with an edge, he can be scary good.
Averaged about five assists a game last year. He's up for the Bob Cousy Award. He's on a watch list this season. A backdoor cut not made, and Davidson throws it away.
One of the things you have to do, and this is a Davidson team that in the prior meetings with Duke, and they've lost, I think it's 13 straight, whatever it is, they've played them, say, in 4 and 8 minute segments well, but then that inability to score pinches you here in this building.
Harrison lines up at 3, and that's the first one they've missed. They had connected on 3 in a row. So now Davidson in transition. Remember how close they came to upsetting Marquette in the NCAA
yes.
tournament last year? They had that late lead.
5-point lead.
Wound up losing a heartbreaker. They squandered that lead, lost 59-58 round two, and nice hesitation there by DeMond Brooks. Today, it gave them fits in a meeting last year. You know, the Blue Devils won that rather handily by 17, 67-50. Hood denied there, slapped away, wanted back. He'll bank it in. Well, he's got a lot of game.
He does. This is a guy who Mike Krzyzewski, when he played at Mississippi State as a freshman, he was all SEC freshman team. But he was a spot-up shooter, made 47 threes. Last year, Mike Krzyzewski said, I need you to become a playmaker. And he committed to it, and he can clearly do it.
They want Brooks to touch it virtually every time, and a foul there in the lane with 13:20 to go. College basketball back on Tuesday night with a State Farm Champions Classic on ESPN at 7:30. Keith Appling and the Spartans take on Julius Randle and the Wildcats. Then at 9:30, the freshmen take center stage. Andrew Wiggins leading the Jayhawks against Jabari Parker and the Blue Devils. Michigan State, Kentucky, Kansas, and Duke, Tuesday on ESPN. What a night.
How about those matchups?
Back door there, and it's Belford to connect. He's usually their first sub off the bench. 6'9", about 210.
Playing with that mask on his face. Close scrimmage against Texas, and he breaks his nose.
4-point game, so Davidson, as we expected, has closed it up. Nice back shot there by Rodney Hood. He's kind of taken over offensively.
What do you notice about that guy? He plays at his pace. He doesn't let anybody speed him up.
He has 9. Sullivan running the point now, the sophomore out of Ohio. The 3-pointer, too strong. Brooks battling for the rebound, but torn away. Here's Suleiman in transition. He gives it up into the corner. Jump shot won't fall there for Matt Jones, but he's a freshman they really like, and that's one of the reasons why, as he gets back and plucks it away defensively. Here's Cook to fire. And in 114 consecutive pulls, that's in the top 10, in 114 straight pulls, Sullivan on the wing. Rebounded away by Hood. Rebound comes free to Sullivan. Duke ranked number 4 and have been ranked in the top 10. So now Mike Krzyzewski is asking Cook to slow it down a little bit here, 21-15. And a whistle away from the basketball here with 11:50 to go. So we have a foul, 20.
Right? How many great shooters in college basketball do you see try to come off multiple screens and they're either being pushed 2 or 3 feet off their path, jersey held? All of that in college basketball should now go away. But folks, you have got to be patient with the officials because we're going to have some high whistle games. There's another whistle.
Yep, holding foul here. And that personal foul will go against Belford as well. So he picks up his second quick one.
Don't indict the officials for doing what is asked. Bing. Contact, whistle.
And a whistle and a foul here. Clearly a blocking foul on the block by Cheripovich. And that'll be his second.
Now, I've got to be honest with you. The hardest, and we can talk a little bit about this later, should an event happen where we need to look at the block charge. Block charge, toughest call in basketball. Every official will tell you that. So John Adams, the head of the officiating for NCAA, comes to ESPN, gives us, you know, a video to look at. Honest to God, until they slow the block charge replay and the rule specific to it, which is on the gather motion, that defense, or excuse me, on the rise up, on the movement upward, that offensive player, the defender's got to be in place. Dave, they had to slow it frame by frame before I caught the upward movement.
So you really wonder what hope do the officials have.
Oh, brutal.
If that's the case, but you're going to hear a lot about block charge plays And a change in the rule. Kalinowski just off the front of the iron. And Parker comes out of there with it. Up ahead for the freshman. Jones trying to operate. He draws the foul. 11:28 to go. Let's go back to that now and a further explanation of what you're talking about on block charge.
Right, and I misspoke because the NBA is distinct from this. The NBA rule is on the gather where you see right there on the airborne player, it's his upward motion. And here's what I think it does to officials. Instead of officiating the defense, which is their instinct and what they've been taught for years, I think on this particular play, you've got to officiate that offensive player. The first thing you have to determine is he in his upward motion? And then in that split second, look at the defender. Tough call, to me, becomes tougher.
Jones looking smooth at the line there. The 6'4 freshman from DeSoto, Texas. 24-15, biggest lead of the ball game now for the Blue Devils. Here's Jack Gibbs. He's a freshman that Davidson is very, very fond of. He's going to see serious minutes this season. Kalinowski down the lane, lays it up and in.
Better possession. A lot of ball movement, less dribbling, a lot of movement. And what happens is the defense starts to shift. Somebody's in closeout, and you go right by him on the dribble drive. Well done.
Parker bodied up and again shoved before the shot as he's fouled by Droney, number one on Tom Droney. Jabari Parker's dad, Sonny, is a first-round NBA draft pick in 1976 of the Golden State Warriors. He played 6 years in the NBA. He has two uncles who played in the NFL. A pull-up pop, nice sweet touch there as Duke strikes. The back iron too strong. Droney off target. Suleiman battling for that. Here's Thornton. Parker with a quick step. Nice swing up top for Suleiman. And he got it. Three-pointer.
Well, Duke in transition, so dangerous. And Rashid Suleiman, we sort of anticipated a guy who got a lot of starts as a freshman would be the starter at two. It hasn't played that way. So he comes in on the second unit. He's the lead guard unless he's playing alongside of somebody. But watch what happens. This is what this guy's capable of. Board it, rip and run, right? Everybody goes. Jabari Parker, extend the defense once, reverse it, wide open, uncontested shot.
29-17. Sullivan pushed out deep on the wing. Brooks having a little trouble with it in midcourt. Davidson's hit just one of their last six from the field. Sullivan trying to help that number out, but that's shy again. Parker off the fake beyond the three. Yes! Sweet touch by the freshman. Freshman in name only. He is enjoying his first half at the college level in front of the Cameron Crazies.
Stage fright? No. Jabari Parker is prepared to play. What a dynamic 6'8" forward. 235 pounds of basketball skill. And it doesn't, and here's what he does that's unique. And this is where everybody around him has got to adjust. How many different places on the floor have we seen Jabari Parker? Right? We've seen him at the rim. We've seen him on the perimeter. We've seen him think about putting it on the deck in an attack. Mike Krzyzewski likened this group to what he does with the Olympic team, where there's no definitive position. He said, this guy's positionless. We're going to put him wherever we think he's best suited to take
speed,
advantage of the skills.
Speed,
how about that vision? That's a pretty good pass. Then in the corner jump shot, just off a little drive from Rodney Hood. So multiple places on the floor in transition, that trail three, get the defense backed off with that little up fake and step back. Really nicely done.
Blue Devils have beaten Davidson 24 consecutive times, including 15 straight here at Cameron Indoor. And now they have opened up a 32-17 first half lead. Droney. Brooks with a touch. Up against Parker. Into the lane. Pretty shot.
When they have gotten the ball to him in the post, he's been able to do very good things with it. He's got 8 points now. And again, he's undersized, so he's got to face up and use his athletic ability to try to get some shots off. And I would attack Parker on the defensive end. I think that's the area that young man has the most growth potential.
Parker up high, back to the point guard, Cook. Cook on the penetration, airborne, draws the contact. He'll go to the line to shoot two with 8:46 to go in the half. The ESPNU has a doubleheader of college football on Saturday. First at 4, it's an ACC contest. The Wolfpack attempting to get their first conference win of the season. They take on the Blue Devils then at 8. To bring you a battle in the Mountain West between the Aggies and the Rebels. ESPNU's college football Saturday at 4 and 8 on ESPNU.
Lots of excitement around the Duke football program. 6-2. If they can beat NC State, they'll welcome a Miami team the following week. That's not 100% physically.
Well, Parker coming out to a very nice round of applause here to get a breather with just under 9 minutes to go in the half. Cook knocks that down. Good foul shooter, 84% of his career, and he has 6 points in the half. 33-19. Brooks backing down on Hairston and may have forced that shot a bit. Cook wants to run. They really want to push the tempo every chance they get. Duke has won 101 consecutive non-conference home games. On the baseline, very tough shot. Oh, what a fine touch by Hood.
So on successive possessions, you see Mike Krzyzewski's offense allows his guys to make plays. They basically clear a lane for Cook, and then they clear it for Hood and let him go one-on-one.
He has 11 in the first half and plenty of time left. Brooks, the senior, with a kick out here for Gibbs, and it's way too strong. Rebound tip to Cook. Quickly down the lane, looking for a cutter. Great give, Thornton. He lays it in, and he'll go to the line for a three-point play. Duke with a beautifully run break.
Top five in the country consensus. Not yet what they will be, Duke, but they're deep, they're fast, they're versatile, and they can run.
Put on a show. How about another highly touted freshman? Kentucky's Julius Randle, the rebound and putback. He's got 5 points, three rebounds, though they trail UNC Asheville early, guys.
Well, we're talking about outstanding freshmen to watch. Talking about Andrew Wiggins at Kansas. We're watching Jabari Parker, Julius Randle at Kentucky.
That was an audio issue. We were not blown away by how good-looking Dari Noka and Tino Gaudio are. Although that we do think that.
Already knew that. Thornton completing the three-point play.
They have been working hard in studio all day.
They really have. Well, here's the biggest lead, 38-19 for the Blue Devils. They have the offense in sync right away. They've made the last five. Davidson has missed 8 of their last 10. On the drive, Barham, and knocks it down.
Well, he's their best athlete, Barham, and capable of those kinds of plays exactly. And against a team like Duke that is going to be athletic and pressure and try to be like the vintage Duke teams that scare you a little bit with their defense once they get there, you've got to be able to use the deck wisely. Good drive.
Jump shot, long one from Sullivan, who's feeling it early. He may have taken a knock there. He's limping up the court, but he has 8. 8 points coming off the bench. Droney working his way in, no, with the left hand. And now Rodney Hood, who has been so impressive around the back here. Sullivan in the paint, tough shots. That won't go, but a little shove there as he's fouled in the lane with 6:46 to go in the half.
Sullivan felt a lot better when the ball found him. He wasn't hurting. But it's good to see this young man play well, because when you start your freshman year and then don't your sophomore year, it could be a little bit of a crisis of confidence. How do you react to the challenge? Because I think in the long run, as much as I love Tyler Thornton as a basketball player, I think Duke might be at its best if Sullivan can emerge as that starting two guard.
One of the things they, as Suleiman goes to the line here, they really like about Thornton is he's a glue guy.
Yeah.
And he's an outstanding communicator.
You know, in this program and for most college basketball coaches, communication is a highly valued skill. And the best talker on Duke is Tyler Thornton.
Also a co-captain from Mike Krzyzewski, who has opened up a 20-point lead. Up top here for Brooks. He's got a lot of touches here in the first half, and another one here. Boy, that's a tough drive to defend.
That's a good-looking move, and that is something that's grown over the course of his career. Bob McKillop challenging him to add layers to his game.
He has 10 points. Cook to direct traffic now to Junior. Averaged 12 points a game last season. He can fill it up as well. Not this time, and a rebound comes to DeMond Brooks, who averaged 14.6 rebounds a game for Davidson a season ago. And the shot will be up and count that one. Boy, tough one for Groney, but he got it to go and goes to the line.
Now, a year ago, Dave, do you think that that would have been called a foul? Maybe, maybe not. But this is what is expected of these officials. Those kinds of fouls. And we can't be critical of them now. They've been given the mandate to officiate this way. Means we could have some games where there's 50 fouls.
That was number one on Cook. Groney, an 84% foul shooter last season. And a three-point play. They really needed that one. The Wildcats did. Davidson will again tackle one of the tougher schedules in the country this season. Duke, North Carolina, Virginia, Wichita State, possibly Temple. They're really going to have a very difficult run, but Bob McKillop likes it that way.
And they dropped it to a 2-3 zone here, just try to disrupt the rhythm of Duke just a bit, try to make them execute against it.
Shot clock down to 9 now for the Blue Devils. Thornton, the swing here, Hood into the lane, lays it in. 13 points for the transfer, Rodney Hood.
Outstanding movement without the basketball, put him in position to make the catch where he did.
Barham off the window, it's not there. Big tussle for the rebound, Hood comes away. He's been cleaning up on the glass. He has 5 rebounds.
He's a stat stuffer. He's going to board it, score it, and pass it.
Under 5 minutes to go in the first half. Parker traveling with it. Didn't quite have control of it when he started his move. 4:48 to go. Duke has done a tremendous job of not turning the ball over. That was their first turnover. First
half.
So a very clean half so far for the number 4 team in the country.
And think about the pace at which they're trying to play. Now, I'll be honest with you. I think Mike Krzyzewski would look at this tape from a transition standpoint and say, definitely pleased, but I think this team can go faster than they've shown here. And that's some of that is mindset.
Tom Groney, the senior out of Pittsburgh. Top Belford, he can shoot it and knocks it down. Is a good mid-range jumper, and he has 4 points in the first half. 43-28 Duke. Duke has sold out every game here at Cameron Indoor since November 16, 1990. And with plays like that, they're going to keep on selling out.
How about that? Parker now with his 11th point, and that one off a back-to-the-basket move. The first time we've seen him in a post-up.
Foul here stops the clock with 4:05 to go in the half. That'll be on Jones. Matt Jones is second.
Well, Hood is going to check out, but watch his little bit of movement, okay? He's on the near side elbow, but the ball is swinging, so he's just sort of playing at his own pace, gets the defense moving. That little up fake gets the defender, and he goes right to the rack. I love Hood's game.
It's a great weapon for him, that head fake. 13 points, missed only one shot. Along with 5 rebounds. So Groney at the line for a 1-1.
Only the 3rd sophomore captain under Mike Krzyzewski is Rodney Hood. And how unusual that you come from another school, as you said, minimal transfers under Mike Krzyzewski. but he was such a good practice player and did such a good job in his year off for the redshirt that Mike Krzyzewski and the team elect him their captain.
Roney makes the pair. Give him 7 in the first half. 15-point lead here for the Blue Devils.
And not out of range. You showed zone. Now you're going to extend a little bit of pressure if you're Bob McKillop. You're just trying to mix things up, go possession by possession, and get back in it.
Davidson, a team with plenty of experience. They also have 5 walk-ons on the Wildcat roster. Suleiman off the fake. Under 4 left in the opening half on opening night. Parker on the baseline. Finds Cook. Nice swing here. Thornton got the 3-pointer. They've done that several times here in the first half to find the open man beautifully.
Amazing when the ball reverses sides, how many times you get an easy opportunity.
Roney. And foul on the play by Suleiman, who didn't think so. 3:31 to go in the first half.
Well, dynamic 6'8" forwards. Rodney Hood, the lefty, off the pull-up jumper. Yeah, that's money. Jabari Parker made his first shot, hasn't slowed down since. Jumper is talked about with Jabari Parker, and perhaps Dino Gaudio might take a look at this. Using him a little bit like LeBron James was used on the Olympic team, meaning that there's no set position and that they would move him around the floor. And I think hopefully Dino has some time to sort of document all of the different ways we've seen him go back to the basket, make a standstill jump shot, use the dribble for a pull-up, use that little step at shot fake to get another clean look. There's so much to this guy's game.
Tom Groney back at the line and shooting 2 here after being fouled by Suleiman before the break. One of Davidson's big guards at 6'6".
You can tell Davidson's going to have another very good year.
17-1 in the Southern Conference last year. Duke would go 14-4 in the ACC, second place behind Miami, and advance to the Elite Eight, losing to the eventual national champion Louisville. Shot clock at 15 now for Duke. Parker to catch and shoot, and drills in a 3-pointer. He has been cooking. 14 in the first half for the freshman.
And working hard defensively. Right? Did a nice job to fight Damon Brooks, try to use his speed to get around in a post. He's working hard defensively.
Jabari Parker 5-for-5 from the field, 3-for-3 beyond the 3-point line, and 14 points. A rather nice first half in his debut. Here's the shot by AC off target. Joe AC, just a freshman, on the run. Here's Harrison, a bump, and down he goes. A foul on the play with 2:34 left.
How about that pass from Jabari Parker? One hand covered almost the entire floor. You want to trigger a fast break quickly? Look at this pass. This is how you play fast basketball. He took one dribble, saw a teammate, and with one pass covers about 84 feet. Nicely done.
AC with the personal. Harrison at the line. Josh, a 6'8 senior, real battler in their post rotation.
He's their best post defender.
We saw last year, most games, he would take more charges than anybody. 52-32. So Duke on their way to over 100 in their season debut. And now up by 21. Getting a lot of contributions. 8 different Duke players have scored in this half. Mike Krzyzewski has to love that. It's part of their depth. Should be a real big thing for them. Suleiman with the theft, and he's denied the foul with 2:20 to go.
They're not there yet, okay? But that play by Suleiman, the board by Jabari, and the push, this is what they're capable of. When Duke had its best teams, right, you always say make the simple pass. They made the simple pass darn near impossible. It was scary making an entry pass from the point to the wing. Now, they're not there yet. but you can see the potential that exists defensively with this Duke team. The athleticism on the wings like Suleiman. You know, Parker using his speed and ability to be a shot blocker, rebounder. You got two really good ball pressure guards in Tyler Thornton and Quinn Cook, because Quinn Cook has elevated his game as a ball pressure point guard defender. I mean, I tell you, the upside, as well as they played, the upside for Duke is incredible.
Gibbs banks it in heavy traffic. Difficult shot for the youngsters. First bucket. 55-34. Parker looking to set a screen. Here's Hood. And Rodney Hood showing a lot of elements to his game. So on the line driver. And it's tipped away. It'll be Davidson basketball here. And Duke used an 18-4 run about midway through the half to really take control of this and lead it 55-44.
It's like a prize fight. You're in the ring for the first 4 minutes. You're pretty much locked up, and then all of a sudden the haymakers start throwing.
Gibbs fires too strong, and there's a whistle in the lane with a minute 35 left. This will go against the Blue Devils.
So lots of whistles. Clearly a lot more whistles than even a season ago.
That'll be Thornton's foul. He commits his second. So Brooks to the line. Pretty good foul shooter at 75%. Are you noticing that the officials are doing a lot of coaching as well?
Yeah.
This particular crew, as Thornton comes out to a very nice hand. The officials explaining why they're making certain calls. And of course, on a spin move here on the baseline, that won't fall, but Brooks is up and in for two off the miss by Kalinowski. 13 for Brooks.
He's an exceptional leaper, and he's got a very good second jump, Damon Brooks.
1:15 left in the half. Suleiman forced it up there, batted away. Davidson wants to run. Tipped away, looked like it was off the sneaker. Hood down the lane and draws the foul. He'll be shooting two. So Davidson turned it over quickly. Brooks with a foul, that's number one.
Just looking to get in the locker room if you're Davidson. Just try to settle down. You come out the second half, you're playing 4 minute segments. Maybe you get a look at some of your younger guys off the bench. Give them some time in a tough environment, get their sea legs underneath them.
This fire by Hood, who hit 66% as a freshman at Mississippi State. Hairston back on, Parker out for the Blue Devils.
He didn't take a ton of free throws. As I said, he's more of a spot-up shooter. He's 27 for 41. Incredible, because he could get triple-digit free throw attempts this year easily to me, Rodney Hood.
Left-hander missed the pair of those, but Suleiman there for the rebound. McKillop was not happy with that effort in a rebounding frame. Under a minute now before halftime at Cameron Indoor. Andre Dawkins has returned to the Blue Devils. He wears number 34. Sat out last season, continuing to deal with his sister's death back in 2009. The tragic loss of his sister Lacey. Cook down the lane to lay it in. Nobody picked him up. Give him 8 points. 57-37. Sullivan wants to drive it. Had to adjust, and he did. And a whistle here. Cook went down. And a timeout by the Blue Devils. Cook is all right as he hops up with 24.3 seconds before the break.
Well, I don't think his debut has been anything short of expectations. A pull-up jumper with a defender in his face. He's got an NBA game. How about the vision? At 6'8", you're just looking over two defenders. Hood falls down. Don't worry about it. Jabari Parker sitting in the corner waiting to drain the jump shot. And again, what do you notice about all of these replays? Different spots on the floor. That was a trail three. Now a post-up. This is a guy whose offensive skill set is incredibly versatile. Get him around the rim, he can finish with either hand.
Well, he's 5 for 5 shooting, 3 for 3 from three. He has 14 points and 4 rebounds.
Well, Jabari Parker versus Kansas in the Champions Classic.
Next Tuesday.
How great will that be?
Indeed, on ESPN. So the Blue Devils with the ball 24 seconds before halftime. And their high-octane offense has shown some outstanding moments here in the first 20 minutes. Ten seconds before halftime. Duke holding for a final shot and another whistle away from the basketball. I've seen several of these calls here in the first half. That stops the clock with 6.4 to go. And a foul will be on Barham. That's number one for Davidson.
So is this Parker or Dawkins going to the free throw line here? Parker, okay. I was wondering, was a hold on the screener or on the shooter trying to use the screen?
McDonald's All-American led his high school in the Chicago area to four consecutive state championships. He's also the Gatorade Player of the Year as a junior. Dawkins out. He said the other night at their first public scrimmage, I'm back. Said, I'm back, baby.
Yeah, and 34. He roomed with Ryan Kelly, close friends. So he switches jerseys, new start.
Got a great hand by the Cameron faithful. 59-39. 6 seconds for Davidson to get one up in the air. Gibbs with a pull-up three. Off target, and there's the horn down the first half. And the Duke Blue Devils up by 20. 59-39 over Davidson. The college debut of Jabari Parker, and certainly an outstanding start. Off to the races, indeed. 59-39. Duke with the lead over Davidson. Let's get it back to the studio for half.
He delivers off the dribble drive.
What a dynamic start for these two. As Parker pours in 16, doesn't miss a shot. Rodney Hood, 6 out of 7 with 6 rebounds and 13 points. And Duke with a sizable lead heading into the second half and the basketball here at Cameron Indoor. So a fine start for the Blue Devils. And if you're the Wildcats or Bob McKillop, what are you telling your team at halftime?
Well, you're playing four-minute segments, and this is about pride of program.
Put down the lane and a quick strike.
Wow, a little shimmy shake. How good is that? The lefty slithers through multiple red jerseys.
He has 15 points. Both he and Parker so impressive in the first half. A reaching foul there on Jabari Parker. As he picks up the personal, seconds into the second half, that's number two.
Maybe the scariest thing, Dave O'Brien, is as well as they played Duke. I mean, there's still so much growth potential here.
Yeah, that is frightening for their opponents.
I mean, they can get better defensively. They can become scary in the passing lanes. The pressure they can apply.
Kalinowski knocked away. Here's Brooks on the baseline. Difficult move underneath the iron, but draws the foul with 19-18 to go.
Do you think Mike Krzyzewski's stomach and nerves and jitters have...
Think they've gone away, settled down a little bit?
Perhaps.
957 wins. Winning his coach in NCAA history, four-time national champion and 12-time national coach of the year. And he admitted before the game, yes, I do get nervous. He said, I'm really nervous. I'm anxious going into this game.
And obviously, there's not a circumstance or situation Mike Krzyzewski has not faced as a coach, but this wasn't an unknown group. A year ago, you go in with three seniors, Seth Curry, Ryan Kelly, and Mason Plumlee. Hard workers, great understanding of the system, really good basketball players. And how about his discussion of the Olympic team, saying how terribly nervous he was before the gold medal match?
He said never more nervous than actually each of those games leading up to the gold medal, including the gold medal, because they're all knockout games.
Correct. Medal
one
round.
One lost to go home. That's
one
right.
One and done.
Quite difficult angle there for Jefferson as he gets hit, draws the foul. Women's basketball is back with a huge matchup early in the season. The Blue Devils taking on the Golden Bears. Brittany Boyd and Jennifer Brandon hoping to lead Cal's up-tempo attack against the All-American Chelsea Gray. Women's college basketball, Duke and Cal on Sunday.
Well, one Final Four participant from a year ago, Cal, Lindsey Gottlieb, did a great job and has done a great job at Cal. Duke, however, is the team right below UConn, and the team, I believe, from a talent standpoint, has the best opportunity to try to prevent Gino Auriemma and the UConn Huskies from getting yet another national title.
But can anybody do that?
No.
As good as Connecticut is, and they take on Stanford, it stores on Monday.
Unless an injury pinches Gino Auriemma's team, because they're not especially deep, unless a major player goes down with an injury, I have a hard time seeing somebody beat them.
Sharapovich gives it up here to Sullivan. Working on Cook on the drive. Sealed nicely there by Thornton, who came over to defend. It's Brooks again. He gets double teamed, trying to get away from that. Sharapovich trying to find that lane. Down he goes. It won't drop, but the follow is up and good by Droney.
Yeah, good job. Droney and was in the right corner, and I thought if they reversed the ball, he was going to get a very good look from three, and Droney is an exceptional shooter.
Senior out of Pittsburgh's had a good game so far with 11. Good back out for Cook. And now Thornton directing some traffic here. Just a couple of minutes into the second half. Tyler Thornton, a co-captain. Jefferson got in close, drew contact there. He really went to that iron hard. That's going to be the third foul for Brooks. So number three on DeMond Brooks. A little Twitter battle going on here between the Currys. Officially a bet, two boxes of Sour Patches.
That's important stuff.
Throwdown on the Sour Patches.
I'll tell you, I was in Madison Square Garden when Stephen Curry went absolutely crazy.
I remember watching that.
And we had Duke shortly thereafter, and it was so great getting a chance to talk to Seth. I said, you know, what, you're watching the game, what's your reaction? He said, I was in awe of my brother. I mean, how great is that? What a tremendous family.
Parker trying to spin one up, falling relentless under there in the rebounding activity. But does not come away with a basket. Kalinowski high off the window. He likes that shot, but this one won't drop. Battles for the rebound, a holding foul. They've gotten Parker again here, 17:44 to go. And that is number three on the gifted freshman from Chicago.
Looks like Josh Hairston's going to replace him.
So Jabari will step out. He has 16 points. Finally missed a shot. 5 out of 6 in his college career. Sharapovich has good range out beyond that three-point line, but he'll drive it instead. Here's Sullivan. He lets fly. Not there from three-point land. But a rebound comes free. No good by Kalinowski. He battles again. Short once more. Hood's tied up, stolen away by Brooks. He just ripped it right out of his hands.
Love the toughness. Absolutely love that there's no quit in this Davidson basketball team. Pursuing offensive rebounds hard, and that's directly attributable to their head coach.
Brooks with 17. So he's shown up. He averaged 14 points a game last year and gave Duke a lot of trouble in the one meeting. Cook, the junior point guard, to set up a play here. Nice spin and a fall away. Sweet shot.
Think about the performance that young man had winning that stacked Atlantis tournament a year ago. You know, they beat Louisville early in the year because he was absolutely dynamite, splitting the pressure.
They run an offense that you know is going to be able to pile up points all winter long here at Cameron Indoor. The step back by Sullivan trying to answer, and he does. Ryan Sullivan, a sophomore out of Upper Arlington, Ohio, sat out last year after transferring from Miami of Ohio.
They've got to get some stops, however. This is not completely out of reach, but you've got to compete and try to get some stops here defensively.
Kick ball with 16:09 left in the half. 64-47, the Blue Devils.
Making a couple of threes would not hurt. And think about this. Duke gets 59 points in the first half. 49 of the 59 came outside the paint.
Cook, strong drive, fires it up. He made it. And a foul on the play. Showing some strength there.
He's got outstanding handle. And again, I think when he plays with an edge, he's much better. And listen, it wasn't necessarily a great possession, but everybody spread out. It allows him to use his dribbling penetration ability to get to the rack.
Three on Sharapovich. And Cook, an excellent foul shooter throughout his career at 84%. And a three-point play, well earned.
This team has got to commit to a great defensive mindset, the vintage Duke defensive mindset, because if they do, Mike Krzyzewski could be looking at his fifth national championship. And there are great teams out there that will develop over the course of the year. Kentucky, can't wait to see him. Kansas, Bill Self, all that guy does is win.
Sharapovich looking to take that baseline denied. Off to Brooks, the leaner, can't get it, but he'll go to the line to shoot two. He does not mind contact at all, Damon Brooks. Not getting lost how good a player Damon Brooks is, and his mom is here tonight, Alicia Brooks, and Cameron Indoors.
She's got to be proud. I'd say he was not heavily recruited out of high school. He comes from a town only about 12 miles away from Davidson. Wasn't sure he wanted to go that close. Alicia's saying, son, come on, I can see you play.
Outstanding academic school as well. And a great basketball tradition under Bob McKillop as well.
I like how this young man at the free throw line plays the game. He's got a smile on his face. He says he loves everything about basketball. Practice, pregame meals with his teammates. He said coming out to warm up.
Did he mean coming out here at Cameron Indoor in front of the crazies? I don't know about that.
I didn't see him come out and get tortured, so.
You knew that was coming. 67-48. Suleiman. Tough drive to his right. And the whistle as well. The Duke has been going hard to the rack and making tough shots while drawing contact.
The new rules are a great incentive to do this. If you've got ball skills, welcome back to college basketball, because you will be rewarded for your abilities. Look at this hard drive. I'll tell you what, Suleiman has not emerged as a starting two guard for this Duke team. And we'll see how long Tyler Thornton stays in there, because I think he's an excellent communicator and it's important for him and Jabari Parker to work together. But before it's all said and done, will Suleiman get that spot?
Looking more and more like it. 70-48. Duke opening up another healthy lead. And again, whistle here. We'll go over the new rules and the variations on them, including block charge plays. But the ones we're concentrating on tonight, placing and keeping a hand or a forearm on the opponent. Now, that doesn't mean you can't make contact. That doesn't mean you can't jab and you know, make contact with a hand. But you can't keep it there.
Correct.
That's one of them. Putting two hands on an opponent, can't do that. Using an arm bar to impede the progress of the dribbler. That is no longer allowed. Kalinowski off target, rebounded away by Suleiman.
I think as important, Dave, no chucking a cutter. So great shooters can't be pushed off their routes trying to get free.
Good mishandle the pass on a low block. He would have had an easy two, it looked like. Droney penetrating and a blocking foul with 14:47 to go. And again, Harrison trying to pick up the charge, but it goes against him. That'll be his fourth.
Well, a good hard drive, and we've seen him attack the rim like that on several occasions. And this, to me, this is the point of block charge that becomes difficult, because I think the officials have to look at the offensive player first to determine that upward motion, and in a split second also evaluate that defender.
Roney at the line. The expectation is that providing a longer time frame for the officials to see the actions of both the offense and the defense, the accuracy of the officiating of the plays will improve. That's what they hope for.
Well.
I know you're not thrilled, and I know it's going to take some time to get used to.
No, I'm thrilled for the rules changes. And Jake Billis has made the point of when he's gone back and watched tapes from the 70s, 80s, and 90s. So think about John Wooden's teams where there was this free-flowing, the ball moved.
And I've heard you say the same thing. You're all for that.
Yes, correct.
But we're all going to have to get used to it.
No question.
Early on. And that's the part that might be frustrating for us as well as fans.
Correct. I think fans sitting at home are going to say it's not necessarily pretty all the time. You know, there were exhibition games where there were 60 and 70 free throws being taken.
Thornton open, but it won't fall for him. 70-50. The Blue Devils in complete command. Droney lost it, taken away by Duke. They want to run. Hood looking for the bank shot. Yes.
But what extraordinary pressure they're going to put on your ability to get transition and guard. You've got to stop Rodney Hood before he crosses that half court line, because in transition, look out.
He has 17. Brooks nearly threw it away. Under 14 to go here in the second half. Brooks, strong move, spinning, and it won't fall, but he's back to the line here. Duke leading by 22. ESPNU has a doubleheader of college football on Saturday. First at 4 in ACC contest, the Wolfpack attempting to get their first conference win, taking on the Blue Devils, who are 6-2. Then at 8, a battle in the Mountain West between the Aggies and the Rebels. All to come on Saturday on ESPNU.
So interesting, you think about college football normally being sort of the behemoth program at a university. Here, obviously, Krzyzewski's had 34 years to build what is a titan in college basketball. But a little bit of momentum for the Duke football program right now, 6-2.
You feel it here, genuine excitement about football on this campus. Alex Murphy just picked up the foul. Brooks rattles it in, 72-52. 20 points for Damon Brooks. 6'7 senior from Charlotte. Duke once again making a run of 30 wins. They did it again last season, 30-6. They went 14-4 in the ACC. Nice touch there by Suleiman again. He did not start, but he's piling up points. Give him 15.
I love how he's approached the game. I mean, he's just done everything within his abilities. Very good athlete, so try to make plays defensively. The ball will find you offensively. You can't worry about scoring.
Not there for Belfort, but a foul on the floor with 13-11 to go in the second half.
So you see he's riding him on the way to the rim, and that's exactly why the foul is called.
Suleiman with his second.
Oh, they actually get it away from the play.
Well, into the game for the first time, Marshall Plumlee, the 7-foot sophomore, who's battled a lot of foot injuries since arriving on this campus.
The interesting thing about this young man at the free throw line, really good driver. But he keeps you off balance because, though he's a lefty, he writes with his right hand. So he's comfortable either way once he gets near the rack, depending on how the defense is playing him.
21 for Brooks. His career high is 26.
I just loved watching him play because he plays hard with great activity. There's often a smile on his face. And now Davidson again showing that zone.
Duke up by 20. Hood set the screen. Suleiman gives it up to Cook. Suleiman running that baseline. A long jumper on the way and too strong off the iron by Matt Jones. Jones McDonald's All-American from Texas. His sister Jordan is a guard at Texas A&M, also a McDonald's All-American. Suleiman there to knock one down, a three-pointer.
Only 5'11". He was a ways back from that three-point line.
74-57. Jabari Parker about to check back in. Here's Cook with a long one. He answers with a triple.
Boy, he has really shot it with confidence. I think that's one of the great things about Mike Krzyzewski. He's going to give you the freedom to shoot any open shot. You know, he would get upset with you if you're passing up open shots or not doing your job defensively.
Plumlee blocked it, but the shot won't go for Brooks. Plumlee there with a tough rebound. Crowd loves that as he comes off the bench. This is a Duke team, and opponents better get used to it. They can go deep. They can go way down that bench. Suleiman up against Suleiman. Rounded out. Brooks mishandled the rebound. It's free on the deck. Nice move there around the midcourt area. Taken away by Gibbs. Jack Gibbs, the freshman, left open and drains it. He knocks back a three and a timeout Davidson.
Crazy thing is, Davidson hasn't played awful. They only have 5 turnovers in the first half. Shot a pretty good percentage. But they're still looking a long way up, Dave O'Brien.
17 with 11:26 to go.
Obviously, his Fuqua School of Business. Am I saying that correctly? They've got the K Center for Leadership and Ethics. Yep. 2 weeks ago, they have the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff here at Duke, Martin Dempsey. And I loved his line when he was here. He said, the United States military, nice pass.
Parker can't convert, though. Rebounded away by Brooks.
The United States military competes every single day. I love that line.
I think Mike's right about this. He said the United States military is more respected now than maybe it's ever been.
Yes.
He sees it himself as this one turned over by Davidson. 17-point lead for the Blue Devils. And we have another timeout with 10:56 to go here at Cameron Indoor. How about these two programs, though? Seven NCAA titles between them, and they clash on Tuesday.
A combined 29 Final Fours. And before it's all said and done, we're probably going to have to change that to 31.
I think you're right. 77-60. Duke in command. Parker with a leaner strikes. He's been quiet for a little while.
Checked out with the foul trouble, but didn't take too much time to reassert himself. And how about Andrew Wiggins, number one, Jabari Parker, number two? As good as Parker's been, Wiggins, I want to see Julius Randle, Joel Embiid.
Sullivan short with a three.
What a freshman class in college basketball.
Very, very exciting. Hood, by the way, has 9 rebounds and 17 points in this game. You talked about him being a stat stuffer. Suleiman trying to get free and a timeout. Mike Krzyzewski takes a timeout here with 10-10 remaining in the contest. And Duke leading by 19. They had a 20-point lead at the half. And the youngsters new to the scene here for the Blue Devils, Rodney Hood and Jabari Parker, have not disappointed a soul in this building.
No, and you think about this, in the preseason, as far back as September, Mike Krzyzewski kept reiterating the point that around these two dynamic 6'8 forwards, the returnees would have to adjust. Now, you have some pretty good players. Rashid Suleiman had a heck of a freshman year. Quinn Cook displayed flashes of brilliance. But the reality is these are the two foundations. And it's a little different for Mike Krzyzewski as you see the consecutive top 10 rankings, which you were talking about. A year ago, you have 3 seniors. You go through a scout one time, and the guys go, oh, yeah, well, exactly, that's how we're going to defend that. Not the case. There's a steeper learning curve with this group.
Duke of the basketball leading by 19. Talk about Parker being brand new as a freshman. But as a sophomore, he was with the Duke team last year. In fact, a slowdown by Parker. Jabari Parker gets him screaming here at Cameron Indoor. High up over the rim. Wow. Brooks on a low block into the paint for 2.
I was hoping for a foul. I want to see the replay.
Yes. He has 24, Damon Brooks.
My goodness gracious. Jabari Parker, I don't have any doubt in my mind that SportsCenter Top 10 is going to include this young man before it's all said and done tonight.
Suleiman's wide open. He rattled on the 3. Look out here, 84-62. Suleiman's had a big night, too. He has 18 off the bench. I thought Mike Krzyzewski really coached him brilliantly last year through that long shooting slump. Got out of it. That's a big impact game. He brought him off the bench tonight. Sullivan fires and misses.
You know, you wonder, does this change Mike's thinking about the 2 spot? Does he like the sort of punch he gets off the bench from Suleiman?
It pinballs back to Hood. Off that fake, he's tied up and fouled. In the act of shooting, he'll go to the line. Rodney Hood for 2.
Now, this says a little set.
Cook over the top. Parker takes care of the rest. Now Brooks just picked up his 4th foul.
Just throw it to the corner of the backboard, baby.
Hood at the line, 4 fouls for Brooks. Another one coming for the sophomore from Meridian, Mississippi. Parker. Parker not only with 20 points, but he's missed only two shots all night. He's 7 out of 9. And a make here for Hood would give him 19. And he's 8 out of 9 from the field. Again, he practiced with Duke sitting out after the transfer from Mississippi State, practiced last year. His teammates know him very well, but his fans are not as familiar with him until tonight.
You know what Rashid Suleiman, who has played brilliantly tonight, said about those two guys? He said, Jabari Parker and Rodney Hood can completely deflate your self-esteem because you can play perfect defense on either guy, Hood or Parker, and they'll still drain shot after shot in your face. That's what pros do, right? Mm. They can score against great defense. How about that? I mean, Rashid Suleiman is no slouch as a college basketball player. But that's the kind of ability these two guys have.
Hood just picked up his second. Droney at the line with 8:18 left. And Duke, a very serious threat to hang 100 on Davidson. Quinn Cook will walk it up now, the point guard, with 8:10 left. Parker has been terrific. Jabari Parker with 20. Rodney Hood is 19. Cook with that spin. Off the window, no. He'll be at the line to shoot two. And it's been very common for the Blue Devils tonight, picking up that contact after a blow by.
The floor spacing was great. On this one, it was against the zone. Well, no problem. Go look like you're going to scream. Backdoor lob to an outstanding athlete, Jabari Parker, with 20. That was pure. The corner three off the Rodney Hood stumble. No problem. Jabari will clean it up. How about this? A little back to defender off with an up fake jab step. Now you go back to the basket, and this is something they could go to. If they struggle to shoot the basketball, you can place that guy right there. Do they have a low post guy? No, they don't. But they've got a superior athlete who can get easy opportunities.
He's having fun.
Yeah.
Fifth freshman under Coach K to score 20 or more in his debut. Taylor King, the last one to do it in the 07-08 season against NC Central. Jabari Parker out of Chicago. He is putting on a show here tonight right away. Hit the very first shot he ever took in college basketball. Cook at the line.
Just watch him move off the basketball. He's got a tremendous feel on the offensive end. At last possession prior to this one. You know, he looked like he was going to set a screen. Then he goes to the low post, like ducks in. They couldn't get him the jump shot, so then he just spins off his defender, little duck in. They don't hit him there, but he kept moving.
The Blue Devils with their biggest lead tonight. With 7:45 left here against Davidson. Gibbs. Nice move sweeping underneath and stuffed in for two by Bilford.
You look at a guy like Belford, right? So he's all the way from Battleground, Washington. How does a run, nice jumper, wow.
Parker again.
How does a run like the Elite Eight with Stephen Curry have an impact? You can get a guy who pays attention to that tournament from Washington, because that's how he became familiar with Davidson.
What a year that was for Davidson. They've had a lot of signature wins under Bob McKillop. 2008 alone, they defeated Gonzaga, Georgetown, Wisconsin, and West Virginia. But it's not going to happen tonight. Up and in by Andrew McAuliffe, the freshman out of Northbrook, Illinois. He has 4 points. The Duke with 90 already up on the scoreboard with 6:40 to play. And no signs of slowing down. Thing that Duke has shown us tonight, they don't have to just score in transition. They can score in the half-court
yes.
game as well.
Yeah.
Quite liberally.
They've had good spacing. They've shot it incredibly well from three.
Another triple. This one by Cook to make it 93-67. He has 6.
I think it's understandable why all of the ACC coaches picked Duke preseason first.
Just clean that up. Cook has 21. Another three-pointer knocked in. 93-69. Parker.
Oh,
nice dish.
Pass.
Jones had it blocked up and in for two on the second effort.
Really good pass.
He has four. Five and a half left. Duke bearing down on 100 points against a very good opponent.
Yes, well coached.
It was knocked out in the second round of the NCAA tournament and barely by Marquette last year. So it's going to be a very impressive win any way you cut it for Duke. It'll also be the 16th consecutive win over Davidson here at Cameron Indoor for the Blue Devils. Cook gives it up. Hood lofts it up. Got it. Boy, they're raining the threes.
Quinn Cook has done a terrific job in a half court, running offense, finding the open guy, using his ability as a dribble driver. I mean, he's been solid passing the basketball. Seven assists.
And Hood with 22 points.
Watch this. This is a decisive, and then how about the read? I mean, just a hard drive, quick decisions. This guy knows how to play on the offensive end of the floor.
Cheripovich at the line. Jabari Parker with 22. Rodney Hood with 22. And between the two of them, they have missed a total of three shots. They are 17 out of 20. How about that?
Yeah. They're going to probably take a seat for the night. Thornton, Hood, and Parker. And it's interesting watching practice yesterday and a change on the Duke sideline. Longtime associate head coach Chris Collins is now gone, taking over the Northwestern program. Steve Wojciechowski, who worked for years with the post players, has now switched to the guard. Jeff Capel, there you see the balanced scoring. Capel will now work with the post. And when I was watching them work and break down guard to post, Parker's going to work hard, and athletically he can cover some flaws defensively. But that's something where he'll show tremendous growth here this
Murphy,
year.
Oh, another three-pointer. Before that shot, Duke was making 72% of their shots for tonight. Just burying Davidson, 101 points. Now off the turnover. The bounce here for Suleiman, had to make the adjustment. That won't roll in, but he draws the foul. The second half, Duke has attempted 20 shots that made 15.
Wow, that's after shooting 70% in the first half. 73% in the second.
Wow. That's 73% for the ball game. 73% for the game.
And 13 of 20 from three.
Wow.
And comes from multiple positions, right? Cook
That's
has
right.
made a couple. Hood has made a couple.
Get the bigs draining them as well. Murphy coming off the bench to knock one down.
So the question about Duke was, you know, last several years they've been running their offense through Mason Plumlee. I don't think you need to worry about that. Think about the Miami Heat, right? They don't run their offense through. They don't have a back-to-the-basket low-post score.
So Suleiman has 20. Parker has 22. Hood has 22. And Cook has 21. Four Duke Blue Devils who have scored more than 20 or more tonight. On a scoop, nicely done there by Droney. 103-73. A little cut on the left arm of Parker. That's the only thing that's touched him tonight. That's a pretty play by Emil Jefferson as he gets into the offensive action. 5 points tonight. 105-73. Duke in a runaway. They have blown away Davidson in the second half with Jabari high up over the rim. In a big-time performance in his college
team the following week that is not 100% in terms of their losses, but look at this, 6-2, 2-2 in the ACC.
Four straight wins entering Saturday. Jefferson at the line, knocks it down. Give him 6 points. Everybody scoring tonight for the Blue Devils, but they are shooting at some kind of pace, folks. 73.5%. That's their field goal percentage. Duke hasn't shot over 70% since 1985.
Wow.
You're talking 28 years ago since they had a night like this. They're not there yet. 3:15 to go. The game isn't over, but what a shooting display. Nearly stolen away off the front of the iron there by Barham. And Duke with a chance to get several more in the air before the final horn. They are scalding those nets. They have made 36 out of 49 shots. Jefferson makes it, banked it, counted. He'll go to the line.
You just have so many guys, Dave, where Duke can spread the floor and at multiple spots you can drive the lane. It'll put extraordinary pressure on your help defense. There's your percentages, 80% from two.
Wow. Not to mention 65% beyond the three-point line. You put them together, and right now they're at 74%.
When you've got great players, and you have to characterize Jabari Parker as a great player, right, and he's playing the way he's playing, at the level he's playing, what happens? Everybody else's level rises up because he's inspired great confidence. You can look at that guy and go, you know what? For 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 minutes, if necessary, Jabari Parker could carry us. So all of the attention that the defense throws at him, now your other guys feel really good. Their chest is out, now they go. And these are skilled players around them.
108 points for the Blue Devils, not done, with 2:17 on the clock.
I cannot say enough about how well Suleiman and Cook played tonight. It'll get overshadowed because of the stars and Hood and Parker, but those two guys played great as well.
Suleiman with 20 points, making 6 out of 9. Parker, 22, 8 out of 10. Cook, 7 out of 9, 21 points. Murphy there plucks the rebound. And Hood was outstanding tonight. Here's another jumper on the way, and that one won't fall. A rare miss for the Blue Devils with a minute and 46 to go. But a turnover. Jefferson slams it down. Mike Krzyzewski wants to take a timeout here with 1:43 left.
And he's just going to try to get him to keep playing. Got to use a little good spot, Tyler Ennis. So it doesn't, your grade or age doesn't matter. We've clearly seen that tonight. And Ennis is smart and he's tough. And I think he's up to the challenge.
Droney on the wing. He's had a solid night for the Wildcats. Sharapovich trying to work on Jones around the back for the pull-up 17-footer for two. Chris Sharapovich, 6'7 senior out of Sweden. Bit of a quiet night for him with just half a dozen points. They needed a lot more than that, obviously. 110 to 75. Now it's Murphy out of Wakefield, Rhode Island. Mike Krzyzewski going to his bench. Ogele trying to move into the lane. That's going to be a traveling violation.
So Florida Atlantic is next. Oh.
Well, that's Devon Brooks. And he is down deep into the corner near their bench. They look like they're icing his leg. Quick dribble down by Barham, a foul. 51 seconds to go.
You hope that is just cramps for Damon Brooks.
Foul on Matt Jones will be his third.
And the way they're icing him down, you've seen that often enough with athletes where it certainly looks like it's a cramp situation.
Hope that's the case. He had an outstanding game with 24 points, made 7 out of 9. And hauled in 7 rebounds, assuming he's finished for the night. Certainly looks like he is. Going to the fluids. Barham, the sophomore from Cleveland, to make it 110 to 77. Duke right now shooting just shy of 72% from the field. Pretty remarkable performance here. Plumlee. Sharapovich trying to handle him. The leaner won't fall. And it comes free to Davidson. With under 30 to go. Duke at 70.4%. So if they don't miss another shot, It'll be the first time in 28 years a Duke team has hit 70% or more. Chance for an easy one here. Jones knocked away and fouled. With 12.7 to go, he'll go to the line for two. A huge offensive performance by the Blue Devils in their season opener.
One of the fascinating things to play out here for Duke is, and you've talked about it on numerous occasions, Dave, is the depth they have at their disposal. Now, how do you distribute those minutes? Because Coach Krzyzewski, you think back over the years, his best team, seven guys for sure, maybe an eighth if they're especially deep. Where do all these pieces that come off the bench fit? How do you distribute those minutes? All of these things yet to be developed, but boy, that's a pretty good pair to start with.
Mike said he was a little nervous before the game. I felt a lot better about ever being nervous again, by the way, for the rest of my life. About anything. If he's nervous about a season opener,
yeah,
with everything he's done.
I agree.
Duke with their most points since they defeated Penn, scoring 114 points in 2009, December of 09. And Duke is going to shoot 70% for the night. 70.4. They thrash a very good Davidson team, 111 to 77. What a shooting night for the Blue Devils and their outstanding young stars in Jabari Parker and Rodney Hood. We say goodnight from Durham. Now we send it to Albuquerque for ESPN's primetime college football. Air Force taking on New Mexico.
Dave, thanks very much. A very impressive win for number 4 Duke to open up the season as we welcome you out west, New Mexico.